I decided to learn how to make good renders with EEVEE, and this is what I made. I collected a number of techniques and tricks and stuff, and I'm gonna teach you all of those in a simple scene first, and then I can show you how I applied those in this scene. So let's start with our very basic scene first. This is the simple scene we're gonna work on, not anything special. And we see that our first problem is that the light is bleeding through these walls here. And how can we fix that? We can get rid of that by using a solidify modifier and making these walls a bit thicker. Now you can make this really thick and you think, okay, your problem is gone, but I know that sometimes you don't wanna have such thick walls. The thing we can do is to change the bias of the lamp. Go to the lamp settings here. And under the shadow there's this bias, and we make it smaller, really really small, and then we get rid of all of this bleed. If it still doesn't disappear for you, the things you can try is to go to the shadow settings, turn on high bit def. If it still doesn't work for you, then you go to the lamp settings here, check contact shadows. This might work in some cases, but in some cases it also makes some glitchiness, and use it carefully, right? So this is how you work with shadows. And one last thing is that when you have soft shadows checked, right here, make sure that you have samples at least at 255-56 for the render. This makes sure you really have these realistic soft shadows like you see here. But the next thing you might have tried to do in EEVEE is using an HDR, right? The problem is that in EEVEE, HDRs don't cast any shadows. So let me delete this lamp here and let me enable my HDR from a German Nazi camp. I didn't know it was from a Nazi camp, but it turned out it was. You see, the lighting is not very good. It doesn't have any shadows at all, and it looks very very plain. So to solve that, we have to make sure that our HDR is only used for the background purposes and not for the lighting itself. Go to this shader editor here, shader editor, and under world settings add a light path node. It's not very advanced in EEVEE, most of these rays don't work, but some of those work, and the camera ray is one of those. It gives you information about what the camera sees and what it doesn't. So when you plug this into the strength, the HDR is visible, but it does not have any effect on what the camera sees. If you want to make your HDR stronger, you can use a math node. You multiply it and the HDR becomes stronger or weaker, depends if what kind of a background you want to have. I'm going to keep it at 1 by now. And now let's think how we can get this real lighting of this HDR. Well, we cannot. We only have to fake it. You add a sun lamp and then you try to match it with the sun from the HDR. So this is the sun, it has been matched up. And the next thing is to match the color of the sun. So to do that, you just go to sun settings and pick this color of the sun. And also you want to add a skybox light. So select an area light, move it up, make it bigger, like really, really, really big. And the color should be something from the sky. So something bluish from here. And of course the strength should be something like, you just have to experiment. 2000 looks pretty okay. So okay, we have solved the lighting issue, but you see now that we have some light bleed. Using the techniques from the previous part, you know that first you have to have some thickness, but we have some thickness. So what are the next steps we can try? First we can try to change the bias of the lamp. So select the sun lamp, turn this bias down. This has done something, but not too much. The next step is to check if you have high bit depth shadows. Do we have them? Yes, we do have them. Here the resolution comes into play. The cube size is for lamps that are point lamps and area lights, and the cascade is for the sun lamps. So if you enable a little bit higher resolution, it gets better, and maybe if you enable a bit more higher resolution, a lot better. If you still have some problems with the sun, you can go to this sun lamp settings and enable contact shadows. This is looking pretty much like cycles already, but the problem is that we don't have indirect lighting. And what is indirect lighting? Indirect lighting is when you bounce light rays around the room and, you know, you have illumination everywhere, not just where the sun is casting its light. Let's go back to EEVEE. Let's add a irradiance volume probe. The thing you want to do with irradiance is to match up with the room. So you rotate it and you scale it, something like that. This area here is the falloff, where the irradiance is gonna lose gradually its power, and the inside here is where the irradiance is gonna light up your scene. So let's make this match the walls, and you also wanna make sure you don't intersect with everything. It seems that this wall is not intersecting with these probes here. Let's bake our indirect lighting. We have baked our probe and I also added some more resolution. You see, we have some more points here. The thing here is that we have a problem with this wall. You know, it has this white or a brighter area here, and that's because the probes work in a way that they capture data from all these locations and then they average out in the middle. The wall happens to be in the middle, so we don't have actual information for these areas here. It's just average between this darker part and this lighter part. To fix that, what we can do is either shift this probe But in this case, the best thing you can do is to just shift the location of your wall. So let's see where the probes are. One probe is here, and let's shift this wall on the local z-axis. So now the wall is moved, and let's delete the lighting cache, and let's bake it again. Okay, so I have moved the wall around, and I have baked some different variations of this probe. And now it seems the lighting is looking pretty right. Pretty good, right? The next and the last thing is to use a reflection cube map. Because you see, here we have this ball, which is completely black because no light is falling on it, and we don't have screen space reflections. So let's turn on screen space reflections, and it seems we have something. And as we get closer, it becomes more dark because in EEVEE, it uses like what you see on screen and then reverses it. And because we don't have too much information on the screen except this ball, it turns black because it doesn't know what's behind the camera. So to get rid of that, we have to add a reflection cube map and make this for about the size of the sphere. And let's click bake cube map only. And the cube map is baked, and we don't have this dark spot anymore. One thing before moving to the Star Wars scene is to remember that baking indirect lighting also bakes ambient occlusion. So if you go and enable the kind of fake ambient occlusion under EEVEE settings, this might be a bit too much. So you have to play with the distance and the factor and compare it to cycles to know what is correct. And now let's check out my Star Wars scene to see how I applied all these techniques there. Here I have used pretty much all the techniques except HDR, because it's space, you know, you don't have any sky there. This robot here has a small reflection cube map because it's in the front of the scene and needs to be as realistic as possible. It doesn't matter if the machines in the background don't have the best reflections or refractions or whatsoever, no one's gonna notice that. They're also blurred out. For the indirect lighting, I added two irradiance volumes. The first one is just the overall lighting for the room, and make sure that these emissive stripes actually put out some light. Because in EEVEE, only lamps are capable of lighting a scene, and without baking, the emission materials are ignored. I turned off all the lights, and without the baking, this would be complete darkness here, but thanks to this irradiant stuff, the stripes are lighting the scene. The second irradiance box is in the foreground, lighting the robot and these boxes. If I had used this resolution everywhere in the room, the baking would have taken a really long time, so intelligent people know where to use high res and where to use low res. And the last thing to make more realistic renders, which also is for cycles, is to use motion blur in still images. I have made two keyframes for this stormtrooper and for this foot here. And now when I render this, this gives these characters motion blur and gives the impression that they were moving when the photo was taken. And these are pretty much my tips about EEVEE. Have a nice day, nothing else to say.